Oxygen is the basic necessity for human being and other creatures in Earth to survive. Oxygen is the most critical thing for human being to survive during COVID-19 pandemic. Apart from medical purpose, oxygen find its widespread usage in industrial applications like metal processing, welding, etc. In this video, we will understand how oxygen is produced. Atmospheric air is comprised of three major components, namely, nitrogen, 78%, oxygen, 20.8%, argon, 0.9%. Other components like carbon dioxide, water vapor, etc. forms the remaining 0.3%. All these components exist in gaseous mode and it is very difficult to separate these components in gaseous mode. Conversely, if these components are liquefied, then it is easy to separate them. To liquefy them, temperature of each component has to be brought below their boiling point. For example, boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius and water becomes vapor beyond 100 degrees Celsius. Likewise, if we can achieve the boiling point of oxygen, which is minus 183 degrees Celsius, then we can liquefy oxygen. Same for nitrogen and argon, whose boiling points are minus 196 and minus 186 degrees Celsius, respectively. Achieving this level of low temperature is very difficult using refrigeration technology, which is widely used in air conditioners and domestic refrigerators. So in another technology called cryogenic technology is used to achieve this level of low temperature, which is normally below minus 100 degrees Celsius. Now, we will look into the process of achieving low temperature, up to minus 196 degrees Celsius, to separate oxygen and other components from atmospheric air. First, air from the atmosphere is suctioned and filtered using filters to remove dust particles and other hard impurities. Then filtered air is compressed in a compressor, up to 6 bar pressure, to make the air flow from start to end of the process. If the air is compressed, then temperature will increase due to increase in kinetic energy of air molecules. So, the high pressure air, at high temperature is cooled in the pre-cooling system, to around 10 degrees Celsius, using refrigerated water. During this cooling process, air will capture additional moisture, as it is in direct contact with water. So at this stage, high pressure, low temperature air is having impurities like water, carbon dioxide and hydrocarbons, which is not required for us. Water, hydrocarbons and carbon dioxide are removed in the purification units, using molecular sieves and activated alumina. If water and carbon dioxide are not removed, then they will form ice in the lines, and results in blockage of the air path. If hydrocarbons are not removed, then it will result in explosion, if it accumulates in liquid oxygen. Now, at this stage low temperature, high pressure air is having only oxygen, nitrogen and argon. This high pressure air is then expanded in an expansion turbine and Joule-Thompson valve. This adiabatic expansion results in drastic drop in temperature from 10 degrees Celsius to minus 120 degrees Celsius. Then, this expanded air is passed to fractional distillation column through heat exchangers. Repeated circulation of this cold air through expansion turbine, heat exchanger, and fractional distillation column, air temperature is further reduced to minus 165 degrees Celsius. At this temperature, air inside the fractional distillation column will get liquefied, and this liquefied air is having 40% content as oxygen. This liquid is called as rich liquid, as oxygen is more in content. This rich liquid is taken and given as reflux at the middle of fractional distillation column. This cold, rich liquid will act as cooling medium for vapors coming from bottom. And this vapor will get condensed as pure oxygen, and remaining nitrogen will escape to top. This is because nitrogen is having lower boiling point than oxygen. This process is similar to the condensation process, happening at vessel having boiling water, when closed with a lid at the top. Because of lid chillness, escaping water vapor will get condensed. Here in fractional distillation column, cold reflux will act as the lid. To have proper contact of cold reflux and escaping vapor, inside distillation column, perforated trays will be kept at regular intervals. Sometimes, instead of trays, packings are also used, to enhance proper heat exchange. By repeating this process for long time, there will be a formation of temperature gradient, from bottom of the distillation column, to the top. From minus 170 degrees Celsius, at bottom of the column, to minus 196 degrees Celsius, at the top of the distillation column. Because of this temperature gradient, oxygen will be liquefied at minus 183 degrees Celsius area and collected. Argon will be liquefied at minus 186 degrees Celsius area and collected. Nitrogen will be liquefied at the top column, where temperature is at minus 196 degrees Celsius and collected. Normally, height of this distillation column will be around 40 meters, depending on the production capacity of the oxygen plant. Oxygen produced, using this cryogenic technology will be having a purity of 99.5%. The liquid oxygen produced can be taken as liquid product, and stored in insulated cryogenic vessels. Later, it can be transported to the required location, using cryogenic tanker lorries, and converted to gas using vaporizer coils. This gaseous oxygen can be filled in cylinders, for distribution to end users. Remember, the advantage of transportation in liquid mode is, 1 meter cube of liquid oxygen, can be converted to gaseous oxygen of 700 meter cube. Thanks for watching our video. Subscribe to our channel if you like to access more such educational animated videos. Thank you.